were interested and invite us.
The more and more I'm going in different parts of the country to take lectures or to see young girls, I see that not many are sometimes interested in homeopathy. I mean, they want to probably, but they're a little scared. Ki practice kaise chalegi? How are we going to make money? How are we going to get results? Just before I start with today, you know, the first thing that I do want to say is the good thing about our science is that it's not like in allopathy where you have this diagnosis, and you have either an antibiotic or an antihistaminic, or you have a hormonal replacement, which only targets the disease. That we know. I'm not going to teach you the first year homeopathy. The difficult part is that at least the allopaths have a certain cup. At least the allopaths have a certain guideline. Not guideline. They have everything. They know that if it is hypothyroidism, then all they have to do is start with thyronorm. The problem with homeopathy is we don't have that guideline. It could be a case of hypothyroidism where you may want to give natural mure or aurum metallicum or spongia or lilium tigrinum. So the one thing that unfortunately is a problem with homeopathy is that we have to find our way. And I think that when I went through most colleges and I spoke to all the children, what I realized is that was the main fear. Okay, not that we don't believe in homeopathy, but we don't believe in our capacity. So we don't know if we are going to give results. Now, if we don't give results, we are not going to get patients. If we don't get patients, we are not going to get money. And up till now, everything was fine. We had parents, we had this, we had that. Now we need to start being on our own, And therefore, a lot of children told me that, ma'am, we want to do homeopathy, but we don't have the confidence. So believe me, when I started, also at 23, my husband and I, we both are homeopaths. And when we started, we had the same fears. But you know, what we had is, what didn't allow us to give up. We didn't have parents. So how many of you here have parents who are doctors or homeopaths? No one. So you will have to fight it out like we had to. So we also didn't have parents who were either doctors or had a, already set practice. But Jinal, isko thoda silent kar do na. We had a will to find out, how are we going to survive with this 3000 remedies? How are we going to find out way by which we can be sure? Because it was, believe me, impossible for me also to remember the 10 symptoms of allosocrotina or the 25 symptoms of simisi fuga, or Dioscorea villosa. It was very difficult for me, and I thought, if it's difficult for me to remember, how am I ever going to see it in the patient? But what was important was I knew that the science works. I knew that we wanted to do something with homeopathy, but now we had to find a way to get sure shot results. If that works, we're going to have a practice. Aaj nahi to kal. How many of you know Dr. Mamtora? Does he still come to college?
No.
No, then how do you know him?
Dr. Nimishmita is patient from.
So Dr. Mamtor, during our times, we were lucky that we had some of the best allopaths coming to the CMP college to teach. One of the things that Mamtora told me was, Bhavisha, remember one thing. Rolling stone gathers no moss. We've learned this, no, in school. And I didn't understand that because I never related it to practice. So I thought, what do you mean? He said, you will understand it over the years. What he meant is, if you keep moving from one thing to another, or even for practice, you know, one place, you sit for a few months, you say, arre, yahan to kuch nahin chal raha. Then you move to another thing. Or you sit with someone and you say, nahin, ye style nahin chal raha. Then you go somewhere. When you roll like this, then you don't gather. But when you're stuck with one thing, and you, I mean, not stuck as in stagnating, but I mean stuck with endurance and persistence, that I want to get this done. You know, I want to understand this. I want to crack this. Then you gather moss. Then you gather so much moss, it's sometimes difficult for you to handle the work. And very important is, this is one thing that I have learned through my years of practice. It's a practical tip that I want to give you, and I want to give every, you know, every beginner, I always give this tip. I don't never think of small things in life. If you think of small things in life, you never get big. Don't keep your goals limited. You've all seen the movie Secret or read about it, have you? No. So that is on homework. You all go online. The Secret, you all have not seen it, read it, heard about it. Very good. So this is a homework for you. If you don't do the homework, the next time you come, we'll show it to you here. Okay? So I think nobody will do the homework. It's better everyone wants to watch the movie. The reason I'm telling you to watch this or read or even just go on YouTube and look at clips is about this is, don't look at small goals. I want to earn money. Or I want to get only this remedy in the patient. When you keep your goals small, then you will achieve only that much. But if you keep your goal bigger, I want to understand, I want to find the system, I want to get everything right, I want to understand the personality of this patient, you're going more broader. What is going to happen is the money is going to come because the patient is going to get better. Yeah? He is going to tell 10 other people. So when your goal is bigger, the rest of the things will follow. Yeah? The reason I'm telling you this is, see, no homeopath is ever going to give you these tips. They're only going to give you information. I was also supposed to give you information. I was going to explain you the periodic table today. Right? Which I will do. Don't worry. Okay? But that information is not as much successful in life as these practical tips. Because a lot of people have information. But everyone doesn't make it. The one who makes it is the one who understands these tips in life. So now when you're here, I'm going to explain to you the periodic table, then something else, then something else. What we will try to do is, and that is why I want students to come here, is we want to create people who have a vision. Yeah? And you want to learn more, you will surely get success. But if you learn more, if you grasp more, you'll get success, you'll get fame, you'll get money, everything else will follow. This is how we started. Why I'm telling you this is our story. We started like this. We started with nothing, no money, no information, no nothing, no experience. But we started with a vision that we want to learn something, crack the system, find something. And believe me, things started coming. You know? People started coming with tough cases. We had to take them on Sundays to begin with. Today we don't work on Sundays. But when I began, it was Sunday, Christmas, Diwali, there was no choice. Na, beggars are not choosers to begin with. So whatever came our way, we took it. And then sometimes we spent 4 hours on a case. Sometimes we spent nights on a case. Yeah? But what happened over the years is, we found our own system. We created our own map. It took time. But today we have something where a lot of people are learning now from us how to get successful, how to find that result in practice. Had we started with, I just want one patient and I want the money, I wouldn't have reached here. Today I have about six books, the seventh is coming. Yeah? So that comes because you have to start with the vision. So this is something which is far more important that I want you to take from here rather than the information. If you keep this in mind, information will just stick in your brain. Even if I call you at 3 in the night and I say, tell me the main feeling of aurum, you will be able to tell me. Tell me the main feeling of selenium, you will be able to tell me even at 12 in the night, because you have not rote learned it for an exam. You've understood it because you wanted to, and second, you understood it through a system. So what happened is, what we wanted to find was a system where you don't have to rote learn. Are you with me? Now, some of our work, we've also, the credit of it goes to Jan Scholten. Now, how many of you know Jan Scholten? Quite a few of you. Have you, do we have his books in our college?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Groups? Homeopathy and minerals, no? Okay, so some of our work started with that, but then we've evolved from that a lot more. But what is important in a system? Now, let's come to the periodic table. See, before we come to the periodic table, something as simple as when Hahnemann started, he started only with China, cinchona. Then he started adding more and more remedies, right? So then he started to have 50, 100. Then there were other homeopaths who joined the wagon, right? You had Boger, you had Bonningusen, yeah? And of course there was, what was this? No, Kent came much later. Kent is only 100 years ago. But the very Allens, of course, huh? Herring. And I forget the one who was for Jar, no? Jar. It's actually called Jar, because in Germans the J is not pronounced. So Jar. Jar, Hahnemann's Jar. So these were the first ones who came up then. Then they started proving everything. Achha, now what is very interesting is, what were they proving? What were the remedies they proved? Anything that they found in their surrounding, which they knew because of folk medicine, or not even folk medicine, which was something in their surrounding, they picked it up and they potentized it. So it was as simple as that. Which means that you can pick up any natural source and make it into a remedy after a potentization and proper proving and symptoms. Okay, that's one thing. But once that started to happen, imagine the trouble they had in trying to memorize all those symptoms. That's when Hahnemann said we need a repertory. Yeah, because a repertory will help them to form some kind of a system. So the first grouping that ever happened in homeopathy was repertorization, where similar remedies were brought together under one group, right? Like, say head. Head pain, forehead. Then you had certain remedies. Head bursting temples. Then you had other remedies like this. Now then, you know, more and more homeopaths started to make more and more remedies. And the more remedies you have, now you all know how difficult it was to go through these 4 years of Materia Medica exams. Am I right?
Yes.
Yeah. So imagine the stress that we have in trying to rote learn all these remedies. And what started to happen is also, in nature there is a pattern. Similar things can have similar colors, similar characteristics, similar sounds. Are you with me? Similar patterns. And homeopaths started to see patterns in different groups. That's when your groups came up. Yeah? The spider group. Initially it was one spider here, one snake here, one mineral here, one flower here. But then they started to see, oh, Staphylococcus aureus and Pulsatilla are the same family. Yeah, snakes, lekesis and naja, both snakes, do they have something in common with each other? Huh? You have metal groups, am I right?
Yes.
Acid groups. So then they started to see, does muriatic acid and acetic acid and phosphoric acid, do they have the same symptoms? Oh yes, exhaustion is similar. So it probably has something to do with the acid group itself. Are you with me? Or restlessness. Tarantula has restlessness, Migale or Migale has restlessness, Pteridion has restlessness. So maybe restlessness is part of the spider group. That's when groups are. Now what happens is, when you understand groups as a human being, it's much easier to understand remedies. Even if you didn't know Pteridion in your exam, if you know spiders have restlessness and your examiner asks you, tell me about Pteridion, you can thoko. No? Thok sakte, restlessness is there, dancing is there, ticks are there, because they belong to the spider group. Similarly, in the minerals, you had metal group, halogen group, non-metal group, yeah, then the acid group, the carbon group. So similar things behave in a certain way. Now, what's very interesting, why should they behave in a certain way?
The origin is seed.
So there must be something in the origin, huh, that is coming in the proving. Acids can cause exhaustion. Acids can deplete. Obviously, what comes in the proving is exhaustion. Spiders themselves in nature live for a very short period of time. As compared to a mammal, the spider has to achieve all those, all those functions in a shorter span of time. He has to be restless. He has to feel time is running out. You understand? Snakes have to have deceit and cheating because in nature they are venomous. So the group symptoms or the proving symptoms are actually denoting the origin or the natural flavor of that substance in the human being. Are you getting me? So that's what Jan did first when he started to see metals, minerals, yeah, all these as groups. He said they are probably coming because they are coming from the mineral in nature. Until then, homeopaths were using all these things in proving symptoms, but they were not connecting the nature to the proving symptoms. Are you with me? And it was Jan Scholten who first started to connect these. So we are going to do two things here. We are going to understand the periodic table as groups or as the whole thing, but we are also going to understand where do the minerals get their proving symptoms from. Are you with me? And when you understand that, you are never going to forget it. Because you have learned the story. Do you ever forget a movie? आज तक कोई ऐसा मूवी है जो आपको याद नहीं हो, आपने देखा हो और याद नहीं हो? पर ऐसी पांच रेमेडीज है जो आप भूल गए हो, 50, 300, राइट? व्हाई डू यू फॉरगेट अ रेमेडी? बिकॉज इट डजंट हैव अ स्टोरी. बट यू डोंट फॉरगेट अ मूवी बिकॉज इट हैज अ स्टोरी. आज जीनल, हाउ मेनी पेशेंट्स हैव वी फॉरगॉटन देयर स्टोरीज और रेमेडीज? नेवर. Why? And we see so many, and sometimes they call up and sometimes they just message on the phone or whatever. Why we don't forget?
Because they have their own story and they are telling us a story and their life.
And this is how we discuss. You can ask Zainab also. Zainab is also from our college. Dr. Zainab is, I think, how much senior are you, Zainab? She's with her earphones making the movie of the patient. Movie. Aap kitne saal senior ho in logo se?
Three years.
Huh? So how do we discuss our patients? You know, when the call comes up and then, are you a patient? ओ दैट रेमेडी हाँ मैम उसका वो स्टोरी था वो इस तरह से शी वॉज रेस्टलेस शी लव दीज कलर्स यू रिमेंबर शी हैड दिस स्टोरी विथ हर मदर इन लॉ एंड शी वॉन्टेड अ फ्रीडम हाँ यस वी रिमेंबर दिस वॉज अ केस ऑफ हिरुंडो रस्टिका सो दिस इज हाउ वी डिस्कस अवर केसेस What happens? Yeah, you haven't. This is a very new remedy made from the bird swallow. We'll come to that also. We'll teach you animal remedies also, but that is much later. First, if you're done with your minerals, 60% of your practice is solved. You don't have to worry. 60% of your practice is done to begin with. Right? So what I'm saying is, and then, you know, practice becomes fun. And then we discuss the cases like this. Oh, that case. Just the name of the remedy and we know the whole picture in the background. We've never forgotten it. Because there is a story to it. And also that story helps you to get closer to your patients. And when you get closer to your patients, they confide in you. They get better, they bring five more. You know? So you learn a lot. You know, we have an interesting case and we feel so good, you know, at the end of the clinic. We're like, ha, aaj ye dekha, aaj wo dekha. It could be a simple staph aggre also, but the way the patient came to the remedy, you know, the way the patient explained that remedy, and then you're waiting, are aaj ye patient follow payega, kya batayega, is he better, is he not better, aaj humne naya remedy liya. We also, if you learn the system the way I'm telling you, you will come to new remedies yourself. Don't worry in the beginning about where to get them, you can always call up the clinic and get the remedies. Okay, we are most happy and willing to help children who want to grow. Okay? Now, let's come to the periodic table. Okay? Mujhe bhi ek is pe lagayenge, hai aapke paas? So what Jan saw is, that now he saw that there was a system. And
I was about, say, 1996 or 97, yeah, when I first came across with Jan. And what's interesting is, that was my teacher then. In 1996 was the first, and this man is Jan Scholten. Okay? He's one of the geniuses in homeopathy today. Like you know Rajan Shankaran from India, right? So Shankaran and us were also together for several years. We worked together, done a lot of seminars together. It's only recently that because we have our own system, we've moved independently. But we've been together with Shankaran for like 20 years now, 22 years. Yeah? So it was very interesting that in 1996, this man was our teacher. And we were like not even, yeah, just first year at second year. And then last year, we and he were on the same platform teaching a system. So then we were his teachers and he was listening to us when we did our lecture. And then we were listening to him when he did ours. When he did his. You know? So it was, that's what you can achieve when you do something with passion. Now, to understand the periodic table, let's understand some very simple things. Huh? Let's go to something that you know, argentum. Huh? We'll go randomly and then we'll understand the whole table. Okay? Argentum. Now, you all know where is argentum, right? Argentum metallicum, argentum nitricum. Huh? And you have all done 12th standard chemistry as well. Huh? It is in your metal group in fourth year, which you will be studying. Ag. That is the chemical formula. Now, what do you know about argentum? This is a remedy everyone knows. What do you know about argentum? Anticipatory anxiety.
Time passes too slowly.
On crossing
the
road,
they have a feeling that the building is falling.
They want to commit suicide, but they have no
courage to commit suicide. Yes.
They constantly get these impulses.
But what kind of people? Now let's tell me the constitution or the vocation or the profession of people who need argentum. Why?
Brain.
So it's a very good remedy for examination for brain.
People who are being broken down by excessive nervous exhaustion.
Who gets nervous exhaustion? Nowadays everybody is having nervous exhaustion.
People are speakers.
Why nowadays nervous exhaustion? Stress of performance. Speakers, performance. Right? Let's take one more element in the same fifth row of the periodic table. We are on the fifth line. You know, all of you know through chemistry that we have seven rows in the periodic table.
Yes.
We all know that, right? And we have 18 columns. Ye aapne padha hai. Okay? So tell me, let's take palladium. Palladium is another thing that you all know very well. Delusion of being not appreciated, neglected.
Yeah.
One more.
They want appraisal from everyone.
Appreciation, desire for. This is, you know, palladium ka main thing is keeps. If you look at Fartax Materia Medica, they are happy in company and exhausted.
Later. Very polite, pleasing people. This is palladium mentality. Huh?
So, kind of similar, not to Argentum. Argentum is lawyers, professionals. What do professionals want?
Appreciation.
Are you with me? Palladium also wants appreciation. Acha, aur ek lete hai. Antimony tart. Antimony crude. Let's not take tart. Antimony crude. Antimony is, so palladium, did you all find it? Palladium is the right in the center, PD, right before AG or Argentum. Antimony, dekho, thoda aage jao, wohi line mein.
SB.
Stannum is SN. Also, acha, theek hai, now that you brought stannum, what is the symptom of stannum?
Stannum has, they have long-standing weakness and exhaustion because of, and they are those people who are very well-dressed and who are very professional.
Again professional?
Yes.
Like Argentum. But they are now
exhausted.
Argentum, we didn't have exhaustion. Argentum, we had, he's feeling that time passes too slowly. His fear of failure. Fear of failure is a strong symptom of Argentum. Palladium, we didn't have fear of failure. I'm going to connect all this later so you'll understand it. Palladium, we didn't have fear of failure, but we had once appreciation. And Stannum, we already have exhaustion. But still similar. Tabhi aage jao thoda antimony. Antimony is SB. SB. What do you know of antimony? At least one. Idealistic. Right?
Yes.
Writes poems in moonlight. Right? Write verses in moonlight. So, creativity, performance, being well-dressed, professional, clergyman sore throat. Who was a clergy in the earlier times when there was caste system in India? There was also caste system in Europe. And of course, Hanumanian times, there was caste system. They called it the class system. The clergy was right after the priest. He was the high class guy. He was the very rich guy. He was the very well-educated guy. And he had to always make speeches. So clergyman's sore throat comes from that. So what is common that we see in the silver line? What is Argentum?
Silver.
And that whole line, let's name every line based on one element that you know. So you'll remember. So what comes in the silver line is shine of silver, no? What does silver do? Shines. Imagine I give you all silver glasses to drink water in. Shiny. Yeah? So, they are professionals. They are performers. So, people who are interested with high class things, people who are interested in knowledge. What happens? What is examination found? You want to perform your level best. People who get anxious in exams are not necessarily the people who don't study. They're always the people who want to score the best. Yeah, those are the ones who get the highest level of anxiety. Because those are the people who get the adrenaline rush. Because those are the people who want to score, achieve. So level 5, I call it level. So today, I call all these 7 rows of the periodic table as levels. These are levels also of human development. Okay? Slowly when we finish all 7, you'll understand.